Lake Taihu, with a history of 5,000 years. Prehistoric city surrounded by mountains and rivers. Magnificent capital of Liangzhu Kingdom. The earliest country in the Lake Taihu Basin. Discovery and value of Liangzhu Water Conservancy System. Discovery of the Water Conservancy System of Liangzhu dates back to 1980s. In 1987, in the southern part of Mount Danzhi Tangshao Hill, with its special topographic and geomorphic conditions, attracted attention of archaeologists. According to the Tangshan's site's condition and location, archaeologists speculated that it was built in the Liangzhu period as a flood protection dam. As a result, the Water Conservancy System of Liangzhu made its first appearance. Liangzhu was often exposed to flood disasters. In 2002, on the China Cultural Relics News front page report, I put forward this point of view. From Mao Yuanling Ridge in the west to Luokun Village in the east, it was a 5 kilometer long Liangzhu built embankment to prevent floods. In September 2009, due to the need for infrastructure construction in northwestern Liangzhu ancient city, the Ganggongling Ridge was dug up and it was later discovered as an artificially built ancient dam. Provincial Cultural Relics Archaeological Research Institute and proved to be an early Liangzhu period dam and found 5 similar dam sites, including Tiger Ridge, Zujiafan, Huiwu, Xiwu, and Mifanglong. These dams were located in the valley between mountains. The dam bodies were tall and formed a group of high dams. During the Spring Festival in 2010, there was heavy rain here. From the section of earth, many straw bales rushed out. This was a specific kind of Liangzhu people's exclusive construction technique. When I discovered the grass bales, I was very excited. Then I could solve its dating problem. I asked Peking University to sample carbon-14 dating techniques. The result was before present, approximately 4,900 years ago, and proved to be an early Liangzhu period dam, which was very meaningful. To find other possible dams, archaeologists began to use new scientific and technological archaeological methods. It was 1969 when the satellite image was taken that archaeologists discovered remains of several suspected dams under the group of high dams. The water conservancy systems were discovered out of different reasons. Tangshan site was discovered initially by archaeologists. The system of high dams was discovered because of infrastructure construction. At first, archaeologists obtained information and discovered the surrounding area. The entire system of low dams was discovered, inseparably formed the application of remote sensing technology. By 2013, the dam sites of the Liushan, Shizishan, Guanshan, and Wutonglong were successfully confirmed. The 4 dams were relatively low and constituted a group of low dams. They connected through natural hills of Nanshan and Kaolaoshan with Tangshan site. To equip the Liangzhu Water Conservancy System with the second line of defense, the system of low dams was discovered, and not just help the Liangzhu Water Conservancy System with more dams. Its greater significance was that the system of low dams connected through Kaolaoshan, Nanshan, and was integrated with Tangshan site, discovered in the 1990s. In addition, the system of low dams' western side was connected to a series of low hills. In this case, together with the system of high dams, they formed a 2-level reservoir area, and the overall structure of the water conservancy system of Liangzhu was revealed. So far, the water conservancy system of Liangzhu was completely surfaced. The true face of Lushan is lost to my sight. For it is right in this mountain that reside modern scientific and technological methods have provided archaeologists with a border and have drawn to a temporal close of the discovery of Liangzhu Water Conservancy System. During the Liangzhu period, dams were all manually built. The bottom of Tangshan earthen wall was paved with stones, and the upper part was covered with Loess dam body. Other dams were located between the two mountains and were built up by layers of silt and loess to form a dam body. The role of dam was, first of all, to prevent floods, with dam bodies blocking floods, and towards the surface of the water formed a large area of water. According to calculations, during the flood season in summer, from the Northwest Valley to the Southwest Low System of dams, a large-scale artificial lake would form. The formation of an artificial lake greatly helped the western part of Liangzhu Ancient City improve water transportation capacity, and the mountain resources were fully used through construction of the canal. Water in the dam area could also be led to the surrounding paddy fields. To take use of the water conservancy system's irrigation function, in addition, the rivers around Liangzhu Ancient City were seasonal runoffs, and the flow of water varied greatly in different seasons. During the wet season, dams intercepted excess water and reserved water for use. During the dry season, dams discharged water and provided Liangzhu Ancient City and its surrounding areas with a stable water supply, helping water transportation maintain the normal water level. The history of water conservancy in China generally dates back to the Dayu flood control of 4,000 years ago, but the relics of the Dayu flood control were not preserved. The water conservancy system of Liangzhu was 1,000 years earlier than the Dayu flood control and was preserved well. Its discovery rewrote the history of water conservancy in China. The water conservancy system of Liangzhu was rigorously planned and large in construction scale. Its construction accumulated experience for large-scale construction projects of the Liangzhu period in organization and management, laying the foundation for the formation of Liangzhu Kingdom. Liangzhu Museum